La production agricole dépend de la mobilisation
de la biodiversité et de ses services du sol,
de façon extrêmement forte.
And the services
in the soil. Ce qui se passe dans le sol est essentiel.
What happens in the soil is absolutely essential, not only for water dynamic, aggregates between humic acids and clay are a determining factor for the capacity to retain water, but also for nutrient cycles, phosphorus, nitrogen, potash. Soil diversity is therefore essential for agricultural production, and yet it's widely unknown.
We are
coming up against a frontier of knowledge, the third biotic frontier or border. The first one was the one opened by Commandant Cousteau when he invented the autonomous diving suit 60 years ago and showed the huge diversity in the ocean thanks to this diving suit. The second border or frontier was about the expeditions in tropical forests and the Amazon forest on the canopy, which revealed a huge, remarkable diversity up in the canopy. And today we are facing a new barrier of knowledge with the wealth of knowledge in the soil, and yet we don't know exactly how the soil functions. According to an estimate, the biodiversity in the soil is 25% of the total biodiversity, and less than 10% of the species inhabiting the soil have been described. Why is that? Because researchers have despised the biology of soils. Very few specialists were interested, and it's because the alarm was raised on soil degradation that research suddenly woke up and decided to try and protect this huge asset. Life in the soil. Many species have been described, but if we look at the classes, there are still many species to be discovered. Thanks to metagenomics, we are beginning to get an idea of the potential number of species still to be discovered in the soil, and we have a long way to go, not only to describe, but also to understand how they work and how they interact with each other.
Il y a de nombreux taxons dans le sol.
There are many taxons in the soil. We know that.
Les systématiciens les classent par
systematicians classify them by size, ranging from relatively large organisms such as rodents or small mammals, right down to very small microorganisms, bacteria and fungi.
Aussi quelques nombres aujourd'hui sur
we also have a few figures available regarding the density, the number of individuals in the soil. Take the example of a spoon, a teaspoon with a few grams of soil. There are 1 billion bacteria, 1 to 3 meters of mycelium, several million protozoa, 1,000 to 2,000 nematodes, up to 100 arthropods or insects, and up to five earthworms. We are beginning to understand that there is a lot of life in the soil, and at the same time that this environment is extremely fragile, especially in the cultivated ecosystem. When we are tilling or harrowing the soil, when we are spreading pesticides, obviously we disrupt the biodiversity in the soil, and we decrease the services provided by this biodiversity. Look at the biomass represented by biodiversity in the soil. It's impressive. Take bacteria. More than 1 ton of bacteria for a hectare. Fungi, 3 tons in some types of soil. Protozoas, less than a ton. And the world of earthworms, which can represent up to 5 tons per hectare in some types of soil. If you compare a rich meadow with one feeding maybe 1 or 1.5 cow, approximately 1 ton worth of cow, and 5 tons of earthworms. If you compare, you see the importance of the biomass in the soil. And earthworms play an essential role in the way the soil functions and operates.
À plusieurs centaines de kilomètres de galeries.
In every hectare, there are hundreds of kilometers of galleries, 300 tons of earth going through the guts of earthworms, up to 300 tons of earth. And this is a process which plays an essential role in the ecosystemic function because by digesting the earth, the earthworms are combining the minerals with the necromass, the dead mass or the live mass that will allow the soil to be able to provide all of the services it should provide to agriculture. It's fascinating if we start looking at the soil in a systematic way by the huge diversity of organisms, the way they function. Once we understand how they function, I've told you about earthworms, we can talk about moles, we can talk about dung beetles. Dung beetles spend their whole life assembling organic and mineral matters to lay eggs, and they do a huge work for the benefit of agriculture. We also have insects, arthropods, myriapods working in the soil. These are the soil engineers, but the macrofauna. But there is the mesofauna, also not so well known. Millions of organisms cutting the soil into little tiny pieces.
Le monde minéral avec le
and
monde
again,
vivant, le monde
this
mort,
connects the mineral world with the dead biomass.
Au fonctionnement du sol.
And si vous allez it plays an essential role for the soil. And even smaller, below 200 microns, we have soil micro-regulators, organisms which are very numerous, the functions of which have not yet been poorly documented, but they participate in the main cycle by feeding on the soil, by dying and providing biomass for other organisms to eat and feed on, and they provide the geochemical cycles for the soil. And finally, we have the microflora, either photosynthetic or not, maybe sometimes they do assimilate the carbon from the air, sometimes they don't, but they provide the basis for the biomass cycle in the soil, and they provide the basis for all the functions provided by the soil to agriculture. I would like to mention a few examples of interactions which are useful for agriculture between organisms. Parasitism between some bacteria strains which fixate nitrogen and the roots of some vegetals such as leguminous plants. We can also mention predation
vis-à-vis d'organismes nuisibles
from soil-inhabiting organisms versus parasites of cultivated plants. We can also talk about rhizospheric effects, which we are slowly beginning to understand the importance of. The biotic cuff, bacterial biotic cuff, around the roots of each plant is essential for the plant to assimilate the minerals. We are slowly discovering a new world which reminds us of all of the ecosystemic services rendered by soil-inhabiting microorganisms, which play an essential role for agricultural production. So if we summarize the main four functions from soil-inhabiting microorganisms, we have the nutrient cycle, capture dynamic bioavailability, nitrogen and phosphorus being made available again. There is also a structural effect on the soil. We know it's absolutely essential for water reactions, water retention, prevention of erosion, macroporosity, water will be retained and then given back to the plants when water is scarce. And in terms of erosion, also these organisms play an essential role to prevent erosion. There is a fundamental role played on the carbon cycle, wealth of organic matter in the soil and storage of carbon in the soil. Is a way to mitigate potential climatic changes. By increasing by a few percent carbon storage in agricultural soil, we decrease by several thousand tons in greenhouse effect gas emissions. And finally, there is also biotic regulation of the from the soil-inhabiting organisms versus attackers and pests. Now, if we disrupt the soil biodiversity by not paying attention, this may lead to disturbances and cultivation, culture, crop diseases, and on the other hand, if we can protect this the soil biodiversity, we can achieve very good results. So this is a wealth of knowledge, but it's also something that we need to work on in terms of engineering. We have talked about biotechnology when we talked about cultivated biodiversity, but we could talk about a new type of biotechnology in the soil. Soil biodiversity could be controlled, improved by injecting new strains of earthworms, for instance, that could render a better service for agriculture.